I'm gonna be tired.
Oh shit! And we don't want that.
Staring off.
Okay,
let's go.
Let's go get the energy up here. All right, so yeah, welcome to, this is episode number 3.
Number 3 already.
All right, so 3.
Just like that.
There you go, time flies, right?
Still got a mustache.
Yeah, we could create momentum, right? So we're on episode number 3.
That's it.
I'm Shaun Campbell.
What's up, I'm JP.
This is JP. So yeah, so I guess we'll just jump right into it. We'll talk about the updates for the shows coming up, and then we're gonna get into a little bit of storytelling here.
That's it.
Yeah, so December 3rd is this Saturday. That's the IDFA Universe online show. And yeah, that's coming along nicely. So while people are be submitting all their entries and everything on Saturday, we'll get the video up. I didn't talk about JP about this yet, but I was thinking maybe we could do like a warrior room commentating on the videos.
Nice.
If you're down with that. So I'll let you know on their stories and that, and I'll put the videos up together. And maybe we can do like kind of a vibe here, like in the warrior room, and we'll talk about the competitors as they come on stage, how they place, all that stuff. So you get all the updates right here on the warrior room.
Oh, snap.
So that'd be cool. So we'll have that up next week. So the show, the submissions come in Saturday. We'll have them all judged on Sunday, then we'll do like an update video.
An update.
Contest results and update video. Following a few days after.
That's it.
And then we got a live show. So December 11th in Mississauga at the Meadowvale Theater. Last one of the year. So yes, and it's our first one at the Meadowvale Theater since 2019.
So long,
that's
time
pretty
coming.
Yeah, that's pretty exciting. So that's the IDFA Universe. That's all levels from beginner to the pro. From bodybuilding to bikini, fitness model, figure, physique, transformation challenge. We have people from Quebec, Ontario. And I just got a pro bodybuilder coming in from the States, so that's exciting news.
Nice.
So we just confirmed that. And BC, I got a bodybuilder from BC coming in.
Nice.
So it's gonna be a fairly fun show.
There you go.
And we'll do the results and everything. We'll probably do a live coverage of it on here as well. That's what the Warrior Room's all about. We just encompass everything. The IDFA, Majestic Strength,
all encompassing. Warrior.
And we'll talk about this in a little bit. the Sunny Z.
We're gonna have to get a zoom in on that.
We'll talk about this guy in a minute. But it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool what I just did a few days ago.
That's
I can't tell you everything about it, but I can give you a little bit about it.
Just keep it between us.
So then you want to talk about JP? I put you on the spot here.
Right? What the hell are we saying? We just finished mentioning something that we were going to talk about.
We're going to talk about incorporating discipline. People that say they don't have discipline, you don't have discipline, I can't do that. Or incorporating discipline from other areas of your life into other areas of your life.
Into this, into this context. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Right. And so one of the combos that we were having a few times off camera is how, you know, especially with what I'm doing here, you know, because I see it more firsthand, I would say, probably at this level here at the studio, versus maybe what Shaun experiences at the actual shows themselves, because people that show up at that show, like, I mean, like, that's the end of that diet journey, if you will.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? Like, right? You know what I mean? Like, but for you know, the context that I get exposed to over here, there's a lot of times that, like, you know, people end up talking about how they wish that they had this type of discipline. They wish that they had, you know, this motivation or dedication to be able to really zone in on their goals. And then in this context, they end up talking about it as their health and weight loss and fitness goals. And, you know, like how they wish that they had that type of discipline to be able to execute on that, right? But one of the things that Shaun and I had spoken about previously off camera is how a lot of these people that are talking like this and saying that they don't have discipline, if you take a look at other aspects of their life, they actually do have discipline. They actually do have discipline. They actually do have other aspects of their life where they end up exhibiting, like, you know, a certain level of competence, a certain level of excellence, even, if you will, right? Whether it's, like, you know, whether they're business owners, whether it's in their careers, whether it's in their family life, you know, like some other aspect of their life where they have actually applied this mythical discipline that they think that they're lacking. They just haven't applied it in this context, right? And you know, like with Shaun, we were talking about just earlier about how, you know, how would that, so let's say for example, like in your case specifically, right? Okay. So if you were in that contest prep mode, mm-hmm. right? And the example that I was giving Shaun is, you know, like let's say for example that, you know, because most people end up failing in their diet at the end of the day, it's like when the munchie monsters come around, right? So with Shaun, like, you know, like if you were in that contest prep mode and you're out and about and you're running a whole bunch of, you know, different things that you're doing all at once, and for whatever reason, you're not going to have, you know, the opportunity to eat throughout the course of the day, right? So now the end of the day is coming around and you're just freaking starving.
Right. I think you asked me that question. I said, if it was during contest prep, that wouldn't happen.
Right?
But then we talked about why it wouldn't happen, because it was called prepare. Like, prepare yourself for success.
Yeah.
And a lot of people don't do that.
Yeah. Right? And that's a big part of it, right? Like, so with my clients, that's a key word or key verbiage, I guess, that I could say that that I end up trying to go with them is, you know, try to set yourself up for success, right? So in Shaun's case, he was like, you know, giving an example as to like why that wouldn't happen, right? Like, you know, he said, like, you know, if it was a contest prep mode, it wouldn't happen. So specifically, why wouldn't it happen to you?
Yeah, it wouldn't happen because once I put the switch on that I'm in contest mode, I'm in, like, I'm fully committed. And you always know what your day is going to consist of. Like, if I know I'm going to be out and about, what people always do, they pack their meals, right?
Yeah.
Or even if I know, because I work from home mostly, right? So I'm like, I have the luxury of like being at home and making all my food at home.
Yep.
But if I know I'm gonna be out of the house for like 4 or 5 hours, another thing I started doing was eat, like, if we have your typical meal one, meal two, meal three, meal four, whatever.
Yeah.
I just eat meal one and meal two at the same time. I'll eat them back to back almost. And then when I go out, I'm like good for about 4 or 5 hours.
Yep.
But if I know I'm gonna be even longer, then I'll have something light to bring with me. Cause I'm not the guy who likes bringing around that big,
The
containers and stuff. I guess that max, I'm more discreet. I don't like to, like, because I know that just opens up a can of worms where you go like, oh, why you bring that? Why you bring that? What do you call this thing?
I forgot what that's called.
Darn it!
It's like a six-pack container thing, right?
Thermos bags, whatever, like for your
pretty much
food meal prep bags. A lot of bodybuilders and fitness competitors and all that people have those, or the big jugs of water and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I was never into that because I was always more discreet because I guess I didn't like the, like, I don't know. I don't like to draw attention to myself or stuff like that, like having to walk around with like six containers. But to each their own, because I know a lot of people love it. Yeah. A lot of people love bringing that thing around with them, and that's like that's what gets them through. And if that's what works, that's what works. But for me, that doesn't work. What works for me is I'll eat a lot of food before I leave.
Yeah.
And then I'll have a few meals, but I'll have it in my bag or something. Yeah. You don't even see it in there, but it's in that bag. And then I take it out and I eat it.
Yeah,
and whatever, then I'm on track. Or even if something does go wrong, and you definitely, like, you don't have the food, say, because this does happen, like, you're out longer than you thought, and you're getting hungry.
Yeah.
Most time I'll just try to tough it out. But that's why you always have, like, a snack of, like, almonds or something in your bag,
Some kind of go-to.
Some go-to just to get you through. Maybe have something tiny, then when you get home, you can have bigger meals, right?
Yeah.
So
it's funny, because, like, the way that you described that, you know, when clients have a function, you know, like, let's say if it's a social gathering of some sort, some kind of family event or anything like that, right? And, you know, like, they'll start stressing about it.
Oh, yeah. Don't show up hungry.
Right? Do not show up.
If I don't have a strong goal and I show up hungry for something, it's all there.
You're done.
Yeah.
You're done.
It's like right now, I'm actually hungry. Yeah. Because I didn't prepare for this. I'm actually hungry right now as we talk about this. That's the funny thing.
Yeah.
So if I were to, like, if JP said, we would cut this off camera, we wouldn't tell, because typically fittest people in this world and what we do would typically say we don't do this, but we all know we do it. I said, JP, after this, well, let's go get a burrito.
That's it.
And let's get everything on that thing, because I'm so hungry right now.
Yeah.
But if I would have showed up and I've had my almonds and my rice cakes or whatever I had as a light snack to get me through, I'd have been fine. But right now I'm thinking about, like, because now I just said that I'm
just thinking about food. Oh, yeah. Yeah, for sure, right?
And every fitness person, which is crazy, or even not fitness person, says they don't do this, but we all know they do, because you also don't. You see them, you're not getting the results.
Yeah.
For a guy who eats clean every single day.
No,
and you say you do.
Yeah.
You're obviously not eating clean every single day.
You're lying.
And we caught you.
Yeah, and that's.
And I'm not gonna lie to you.
That's what I end up saying to my clients.
If I go to McDonald's, I'm telling you, I went to McDonald's. But you know what? 80 to 90% of the time, I don't go to McDonald's.
There you go. Right.
That's it.
So yeah, the funny thing is, like, you know, so like with any kind of function like that, where you know, somebody's gonna be like, oh my God, they're gonna have all this kind of food and like whatever, right? It's like, you know, like I'm stressed about, you know, being able to stay on plan. I tell my clients one of the like little tricks, right, is pre-eat, right? Like,
you know,
like,
you say, yeah, pre-eat, yeah, 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 before
it's
you go.
The same type of way where, like, you know, like, you know, because like I don't go out anymore. Like, Shaun goes out more than I do. Like, you know what I mean? Like, but like, and that's even so limited
what?
Nowadays. To where? Yeah,
to
exactly.
Where? Where? It depends on what you're saying by going out. Going out to me is like right now. This is like going out to me. This is fun time.
Yeah.
Like, I went to JP's gym. This is, hey, I'm getting out of the house.
This is out. but like, you know, like, especially for like, you know, like, people maybe watching this or whatever, right? Like, you know, like if they're gonna go out, they're gonna go.
Oh, you mean like on a date
to
or
a
something?
Club or a bar or something, like, you know what I mean? Like where, like, you know, like
I date be... foreign to me too.
And, yeah. What are those? What are those?
Okay, a club and a bar is foreign to me too, but if anyone wants to go to a club,
there you go, right?
Call me.
Here's Shaun's number. but like, yeah, like anywhere where there's gonna be alcohol, right? Like, you know, like a lot of what the younger people would tend to do. Well, maybe the older people too, I don't know, but like, you know, like they'll tend to pre-drink. That's right? True. And like, you know, so you don't drink as much at the place, and like, so you're a little
bit. That's not about being healthy, that's just about saving money.
That's just about saving money,
but
right?
It's the same principle.
The same principle, the same strategy.
The same strategy,
right? Pre-eat, right? Because like,
let's make pre-eating a thing.
Pre-eating is a thing, right? Hashtag pre-eat.
Because I actually had to go do something today and I pre-ate. Like, I had to get up earlier than normal, and I usually have a certain meal at around a certain time, but even earlier, I eat like basically what I would normally eat. Double.
And then some. Yeah.
And I kind of like it. Yeah. Because I usually don't eat today. I don't get like stuffed, but this time I was pretty stuffed, which I left. Yeah. But I was pretty good for about 4 or 5 hours.
Yeah.
So that's called pre-eating.
Yeah.
Or pre-planning.
Absolutely, right? Because like, then if you think about it, like, you know, like if you're, you know, because summertime, if you're going to a wedding or like a party or like birthday or something, like, you know, whatever, right? And like you're worried about like, oh my God, you know, JP, they're going to have this type of food, that type of food. I'm going to fall off my plan, right? But like if you've pre-eaten, so now you're there when you're not starving. And at least when you're not starving, you can make better decisions.
But what about this strategy? This is what I do. This is my strategy. I don't know if it's gonna work for everyone, because you gotta be really clean eater. If you're clean and you're really disciplined, you can get away with this strategy.
Alright.
I'll basically just go, okay, Saturday night, JP's having us all over, we're having pizza night.
Oh shit.
I'm all in. I'm not pre-eating for pizza night. I'm preparing for pizza night. So Monday till Saturday, or whenever when's pizza night? Saturday night? So Monday to Saturday, I'm eating clean,
hardcore.
I'm following it to the T, but I have a goal. Yeah. Not saying this works for everyone, it works because you gotta be like, it's kinda like The Rock even does this, where he has a big cheat meal, but he had to be so clean. Yeah. But if you're cheating here and there all week, and then you do a major cheat, you just had it all.
It just, that's, that major cheat is putting you over the top.
Yeah, but if you've been totally clean, hardcore, doing your workouts, eating clean, and by the time you go do that, it's not gonna sabotage anything, as long as, and then you also gotta get right back on track right after.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know, that's my strategy, and it works for me.
This is a motivation that I'm-
That keeps me motivated to stay on the diet, right? Discipline.
This is a conversation I just had last night with some of my clients. and basically, like the way that we were talking about it was, you know, the holidays are coming up, right? The holidays, you know, like I was already telling them, just like, you know, like, don't even pretend. We all know it's gonna be a shit show already.
I'm not scared.
You know what I mean? Like,
it's holidays.
That's the thing.
I'm not
right? Like, you know, because clients will try to end up saying like, you know, like, oh, but like, you know, I'm just gonna have a little bite. No, you're not, Susan. You know what I mean? Like, or Bill, you know what? Like, you know that you're going face first into that apple pie, okay? We know what's gonna happen, okay?
You know what I mean? I don't know what you could like. For some reason, because I was ingrained in me as when I was a kid, because I guess my mom liked this, those turtle chocolates. But I only get them at Christmas time. But everywhere I go, I wanna have turtle chocolates.
Oh,
those turtles.
Uh-oh.
So you better believe I'll eat a box of those this year.
That's it. There you go, right?
But I'll eat all clean all week.
And so that was the combo last night, right? It's just basically like trying to tell the clients, like, okay, you know what? You know that it's going to be a shit show once those holidays kick in, right? Like, you know, those last couple weeks of December there. So right now, between now and
That's the video. Warrior Room Episode 3. You know it's going to be a shit show.
Yeah. You know it's going to be a shit show.
And more.
That's it, right? And but yeah, like I mean, like when you can do something like that, right? Like, and you use it as a means to be able to, you know, kind of still work towards your goal for a period of time, because then you have, like, you know, like Shaun said, like, whether it's pizza night coming up or whether we're talking about the holidays coming up or, like, you know, whatever, right? So, you know, create at least enough of a deficit leading into it that, you know, like, you can still make some progress towards your goal.
That's funny too, is people see me and they see that I'm relatively fit, right? So that whenever they see me eating like unhealthy, they're like, oh, I didn't know you ate like that. Like, no. Oh my God, no, I do, and I'm not even gonna try to hide it, but I don't do it all the time. That's the key. It's the 80-20 rule, and I don't think no one's exactly 80-20 rule. The rule is just like, be clean most of the time, and once in a while treat yourself. Because if you don't, what you're gonna do, you're gonna sabotage it all and just, you're gonna quit the whole damn diet.
Yeah.
Because what people do, they go too strict, but then the only option is you're doing either you're strict, either you do it or you don't. You gotta learn to live with the strictness, right?
What I end up getting exposed to, what I end up seeing a lot,
live with the strictness.
That's it, right? That's a t-shirt, live with the strictness. down with the sickness, live with the strictness.
Whoa.
Oh shit.
Live with the strictness has a ring to it. I don't know.
That's it.
It can mean a lot of things.
It can go right there.
Yeah, live with the strictness.
Live with the strictness, right?
That's the video type.
That's the one, right? what I was gonna say is, like, you know, with the experience that I've had with some of the clients, right? Is that, like, you know, to Shaun's point, like, you know, he's saying, like, you know, if you're gonna have something like that, you're not gonna do that on a regular basis all the time, right? And you know, what happens with a lot of people is, you know, like, they'll end up, you know, in their head, they don't even realize how frequently they're actually doing it, you know, but they'll end up saying, like, you know, like, oh, but JP, like, I only have a bite of a Turtles chocolate or whatever, like, you know, once in a blue moon. But then you start, like, if that
blue moon tends to be every day.
The blue moon is every day. Like, there was a blue moon on Monday, there's another one on Tuesday.
And the blue moon came around twice on Wednesday.
Twice on Wednesday, right? And it's like, well, like, you know, like, you end up...
Once the blue moon!
Yeah, you, and... For a lot of people, even up until a point before for myself too, I would have to admit, you know, like, a lot of times we're not conscious of how frequently that we're having these little, you know, indiscretions that are happening in our meals, right? You know, because it's only a nibble.
That's why every once in a while I think it's key. Every once in a while track it just to see what you're really doing, right? You don't have to, like, follow a hardcore plan. Or like I don't know, and don't think of food as good and bad and all that kind of stuff, because that's where it gets crazy too, right? Because I remember before, like chicken and broccoli, that's it.
Yeah.
That's the only way you're gonna get results. If you want to get in shape, or not shape, get lean, chicken and broccoli.
Yeah.
And that's changed, right?
I think I told you the story too, like the first time that I did a competition.
Did you eat chicken and broccoli?
There was chicken and broccoli there, but there was separate from that too. Like, it was the first time that I actually ended up having to track anything. And I remember, because, like, you know, like, I used to work in a supplement company and I was surrounded by bodybuilders, people that compete, right? Mm-hmm. And, like, you know, like, although I was generally conscious in terms of how I ate and, you know, like, I was a gym goer and whatnot, I had never actually tracked my food.
A gym rat.
Right? Yeah. And I remember...
That's beyond gym goer.
I can't remember.
Gym rat, don't deny it.
But yet, I had never actually tracked my meals, right? And so I can't remember who it was specifically, but one of the guys ended up saying, like, you know, JP, like, you know, like, you're gonna go in this competition, right? And so the 2006 IDFA show.
That team is way back.
Woo! November, I think there was the November show as well, too. Probably Canadian Classic, right?
We're coming Canadian Classic for the first few.
Yeah. So I decided to make a go at it, and, you know, like, one of the guys had said, like, oh yeah, JP, I'll write you out a meal plan or something, right, like, to help you out, right? So I remember when I was taking a look at it, and it was, like, you know, the whole macro breakdown, right, like, in terms of percentages, right? And I think at the time, I don't even remember exactly, but I want to say I probably had, like, carbs that were somewhere around 35% or 40% or something like that. Like, I can't remember specifically.
Yeah, I should check the book.
I want to say 35% probably, right? And I remember at the time thinking to myself, like oh yeah, that's how I eat normally anyways, right?
Yeah.
No, it definitely was not. Like, so like once I started tracking it, I was at about 70% carbs. Right? And here I'm thinking I'm at 35%. And I would consider myself a fairly conscious individual when it comes to this type of stuff, right? Like, this is back in 2006, so like, I mean, like, you know, the mindset and everything has evolved dramatically since then. But, you know, like, just to think of how far off I was, and never mind, like, you know, like, when I'm having this conversation with clients, that, you know, like, and I'm trying to encourage them to actually track what they're doing, right? Because up until you actually track it, like, in terms of my experience, like, you know, you just have no idea what the hell you're talking about, you know?
Yeah. So, yeah, tracking is big, even with, like, workouts, everything. Like, you know, even with your, I shouldn't even jump into workouts right now, but we could go on to that too. Because even with workouts, if you start tracking it, you start noticing you're getting a lot more results. Because now you're focusing on exercise, and you're like, okay, last time I did this exercise with this weight, I did 6 reps.
Yeah.
Because I tracked it, and I wrote down, before I came to the gym today, I wrote down I did 6 reps. Now I have a goal all of a sudden, and I want to beat that, and I'm going to beat that.
Yep.
And now all of a sudden you just did 7.
Yep.
It's a powerful thing in the mind, right?
Oh, huge.
And then having, like, tracking things, right? So I find, I just started tracking my stuff more so with my workouts, and I've already noticed my lists are all going up, and I'm getting better workouts. And you don't cut things out, because now you're tracking, you're actually writing down your workouts. Before you go, you know you have to do all these exercises.
Yeah.
If you don't do that, you go to the gym and say, okay, you know what, I did a pretty good chest workout. Yeah, I'll just take that exercise out.
Yep.
And then, oh, doing triceps, I'm doing pretty good. And yeah, and then you skip out and you leave, and you didn't do abs, you didn't hit the shoulders. Yep. But you still think you got a good workout. But if you would have tracked it and recorded all that and had your workout planned before you showed up, you would have did everything.
Yeah. Right? I find it especially important too, like, if you've managed to have a really good workout, right, and let's say you haven't tracked it, right? So, okay, you managed to have a great workout today. How can you make sure that you're gonna have a great workout again the next time?
Or, right? Or even this. Yeah, we have good, people have good memories, we don't have perfect memories.
It's not perfect.
Like, so we did, like, because you do a lot of the bench pressing, where you do like 5 sets of bench for 6 reps and all, or whatever.
That's what I'm doing.
So say we do something like that, and you think, oh yeah, I hit 6, 6, 6, 6 with, and I use 135 or whatever, hypothetical weight. And then when you come in the next time, you're like, oh, that was a great workout, and I'm gonna try to beat that. And then you're like, okay, what was that, 135 or is it 140?
Yeah.
Did I do 6, 6, 6, 5 or did I get all 6?
Yeah.
You don't know, but if you're tracking, you know for sure. And you already mentally, like, I knew a couple of, like, pro natural bodybuilders. Mm-hmm. Well, one was actually, maybe we know him, Eric Allstra, for example. He talked to me and said, hey, Shaun, before I go to the gym, this guy's hardcore. This guy is so, like, if you think you're hardcore, talk to a guy like this who just lives and breathes it.
Yeah.
He said, Shaun, he lived in Toronto at the time. I don't know where he lives now, because I haven't been in touch with him.
Mm-hmm.
He said, Shaun, I go to the beach, I sit down, I mentally prepare for the workout. He basically goes through the workout in his mind before he even goes to the gym.
Yeah.
But that's a whole next level. But that's just give you, like, an idea of the power of it. He would go in there and he'd have his whole workout written out. He'd know, he'd even write down what he plans on doing for reps and the weights he's going to use. And he said he'd go through that and visualize the whole workout. So basically almost like an hour of meditation of the workout.
Yep.
And then he'd head to the gym and go do the workout. But then you see the results, the guy's phenomenal.
You're basically visualizing that success.
It's
right?
Yeah, visualization.
Yeah, and it's like, you know, just like what we were saying earlier about, like, you know, set yourself up for success, right?
Yeah. You don't have to be that extreme, but that just gives you an idea of, like, yeah, what's possible.
Well, you know what, like, and yeah, you definitely don't need to be that extreme, but I'll point this out. There's, I ended up seeing this video earlier, and it really spoke to me because I've used similar wording with people before, right? In that, you know, anything that you want to basically do, whether it's career, whether it's gym, whether it's whatever, right? Like, you are within your right to do that at whatever level and set yourself up for whatever level of success that you actually want, right? You could do it at such a level where you're just going to be mediocre at best, Right. And you know what? If you're cool with that, then the fuck is it up for me to say, right? Like, I don't need anything to say about that, right? You can set yourself up in such a way where
fucking guy's dropping that bomb.
you can do it in such a way where, like, you know, like you can end up being good at it. Right. You can do it in such a way where you can end up being, you know, pretty excellent at it, right? And then there's a whole different level when you start getting to a point where, like, you're gonna be now elite at this task, right? And then you get yourself to an entirely different level where amongst the elite, you're just setting yourself completely apart from everybody else, right? So there's all these different levels, right? Like, and wherever you want to be and wherever you're cool with, like, whatever, right? But, you know, it's like, you know, just to your point about, you know, talking to somebody like Eric, right? It's that, you know, like recognizing that to get to these different levels, right, is going to require an entirely different type of mindset, an entirely different, you know, process, right?
Discipline,
because
sacrifice
is the perfect word to actually use for that, right?
Thank you.
Because you know what, like, there's a lot of sacrifice. It's not something that comes easy for people, right? Like, you know, Shaun in general, like, he, like, you know, he's generally always, you know, like, in a pretty decent shape, right? You know, like, and he just gets more extreme. We spoke about the different levels of shreddedness and stuff, right? Like, you know, like,
right now, where am I at?
There was lean.
Lean. Cut.
Cut.
Shredded.
Yeah.
Feathered.
Feathered.
I'm somewhere with, like, cut, not quite, not shredded, we're not there, so I'm in the cut area.
Yeah. I'm not fat. Right? Right?
No, you're the lean. You're the lean. The lean is basically you're pretty fit. Yeah. And if people see you, say, oh, yeah, you're pretty fit. That's lean.
That's it, right?
But then you start showing definition and, or sure, showing veins. You got veins, though. But you know,
there's some veins.
So you're approaching cut, and I'm at the borderline of shredded because I'm naturally a lean person, right? So,
but you know, even to that point, you know, as a naturally lean person, because I'm not a naturally lean person, right? Like, you know, like, it takes work for me even to be at this level and only be lean. You know what I mean? Like, so it takes a lot more for me to get to, you know, like, to a different level of even just to get cut. but what I was going to mention, like, even like for someone like yourself, right, is that, like, the level of discipline that it still takes for you to be able to not only stay at this level, but even to progress any further if you have any kind of goal that you want to kind of work towards, right? Because there's those turtles chocolates and there's, you know, like, the burritos.
You know what the problem is? If you don't indulge in those cravings you do have, they're just gonna build up, and then you got a huge sabotage coming.
Yeah.
And then you'll go off and you'll say, screw all this stuff.
And you go face full of
the next thing you know, it's 2 months, you've been eating a bunch of crap. And then you start feeling like, almost borderline depressed. You're feeling like crap about yourself. You're feeling like you let yourself down, that you're a piece of crap, or whatever. It happens to a lot of people in contest prep, which you gotta watch out for that, okay? So basically, treat yourself.
The way that I describe this entire process for people, right? Like, whether it's contest
prep, I don't even know what's coming,
or my clients or anything like that, like, this whole thing is a big mind fuck. Right? And it will likely be one of the biggest mindfucks that you're ever going to go through, because as difficult as other situations might be, a lot of times when you're going through shit, like in other aspects of our life, we're dealing with stuff that's like more external. When you're having to focus on our own diet, our own habits, our own emotional triggers. I'm an emotional eater, so I mentioned that one in there. It becomes a huge mindfuck, and there's no other way that I can think of describing it that does it any kind of justice whatsoever, because
you're making this difficult for me. I don't know what I'm going to call this episode. Now I want to call it episode 3 mindfuck.
It's going to be the beep.
Yeah, episode 3
beep beep. But the entire thing is just going to be beep beep. You know, but like, yeah, like it's a hard thing, right? Because, like, you know, like whether, you know, we're talking about, like, there's the different obvious ways that people pacify themselves, right? Or kind of like, what's the word? Like, you know, just kind of, I guess, I don't know what the other word is, like, you know, it's kind of like basically buffering our stress. Like, you know, like, I mean, like, some people might use alcohol, and some people might smoke whatever, right? Like, and some people might engage in a whole bunch of other stuff, right? But for a large percentage of the population, one of the things that really doesn't get recognized as much sometimes is food, right? And like, we use food to mask our stress, our emotions, our, you know, whatever shit that we've got going on in our lives. Right, like it's a huge one. So I mean, like, you know, like if we're using food to mask a lot of like whatever we might be going through, and now all of a sudden we're being told like, well, in order for me to hit my health goal or my fitness goal, I can't medicate with the very thing that I've become accustomed to medicating with, right? Whether that's a burrito, whether that's a turtle's chocolate, whether that's like, you know, whatever, right? And it's just like, well, that's not on plan. So right now, it's not ideal for me to have that, right? So that's where the mind fuck comes in, right? Because like, we become, like, I know for myself, like, you know, for that first show that I was talking about, 16 or 18 week prep that I did, and I swear to God that I must have quit at least once a week, right? Like, you know, I was having doubts as to, like, first of all, whether I can do this, right? Like, whether I have it in me, or whether I even want to do this. Right? Because it's really freaking hard.
Yeah, it is hard. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's where it's like they always say, when it's all done, you'll be happy you did it, because it kind of does prove to yourself that you can make if and you can true. Get through a contest diet and prep yeah. and actually make it to stage.
Yeah.
You give yourself a pat on the back, regardless on how you show up and whatever. You made it through all that.
That's the biggest truth. I think that, like, you know.
Truth bomb right
That's
there.
It, right there.
What
right.
do they say? What do the kids say? Hashtag truth?
Hashtag
facts. That's it. Oh, hashtag facts. Keep up it's with not hashtag kids. Truth, that's boring. Hashtag boring. Facts.
There you go, right?
I never say that, but now watch me start saying yeah. it.
I think that basically, like, being able to go through like some kind of a contest prep, or, you know, even with some clients, like, you know, like, just even if it's not a contest prep, but it's like, you know, like they're getting ready for a vacation or some kind of a prep in any capacity, right? Like, they've got a weight loss goal in mind or whatever, right? If you can make it through something like that, honestly, you do come out of this stronger on the other side of it. It's hard. It's really freaking hard. Like, there's no
sugar coating. What's that saying? Anything worth having is going to be hard?
Yeah. Otherwise,
if it's easy, then
everybody
knows it's easy. I'll just swing into McDonald's right now. That's easy.
Absolutely.
Go home and then yep. open up some Oreo cookies. That's pretty easy.
That's pretty easy.
Sit down, watch some TV.
Oh yeah.
Easy.
Easy peasy. Right?
Sleep in tomorrow instead of getting up and doing cardio. Easy.
Yeah. Exactly, right?
Don't come here and do this episode. That'd have been easy. Yeah. I had a pretty busy day. I even told JP I had to give myself a little talk to get over here and get this video.
That's true. That's true.
We all have our times. Like, I was sitting on the couch saying, oh my God, I got up early today. I run around all doing all this stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, so I really want to do this video today. But then you see us here, we're talking like maniacs.
That's it, right?
It's called, that's where discipline comes in, right?
And I think, like, you know, like a lot of times people get kind of caught up in the mindset where it's just like, oh, but Shaun, this is, you know, you love this shit. Like, you know, like, this is easy for you, right? But, you know, here we're talking about, like, you know, like not only the challenge in terms of, like, you know, like the diet and the consistency and the discipline that it takes to do that, right? But even like just this, right? Like, you know, like this is Shaun's baby, Shaun's idea, like, you know what I mean? Like, in terms of, like, you know, getting these videos done, he doesn't even want to come.
I didn't know where you're going with that. What the fuck?
But, like, we all have our days. That's the point, right? Like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like, even, like, oh, when you have a vision with something, right? You know? Like, calling you out here. Oh, shit.
Woo! That's facts.
But when you want it, right? Like, you know what I mean? Like, even though it was hard, even though it was like, you know, like, it didn't feel like it, you're tired, you're this, you're that, whatever, right? It's like, there's a vision that you've got in mind, right?
And that vision involves...
That's what drives it.
This coming out every week.
That's it.
So, in that vision, because even if I were to let it say, oh, we'll do it tomorrow, then what if I say tomorrow and the JP says, oh, I'm busy, I can't do
tomorrow, I'm tired. I'm telling you right now, tomorrow, I'm going to be the same as I was in episode one. I'm gonna be tired.
Oh shit! And we don't want that.
Staring off into the distance.
Like, yeah, because episode one was filmed on a Thursday.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that's funny.
I'm tired. At the end of the day, like that, like, yeah, I'm tired. Right? You know, like, but I think that circles back to, like, just, like, you know, having that discipline from other areas, right? Like, right. You know, like, different discipline from other areas of your life, where you know that it takes sacrifice. You know that, you know, like, it's gonna take some work. You know, like, we're not always going to be in the mood every single time, like, you know, like, to put in that work, right? Like,
well, you know, I was telling you this David Goggins story. I told it probably in episode one, but I'll say it again. David Goggins always comes on there and says, but he talks about how when that alarm goes off and he looks down at his running shoes that are sitting at his at the bottom of his bed.
Yeah.
And he sits there and stares at them. He doesn't want to do it. He's like, I'm not going to do it, but he knows he's going to do it.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of how long is it going to take him to get those shoes on his feet.
Yep.
Because part of his preparation, they're there, but he also, and discipline to do it. Because not every day, I'm sure there's days he jumps out, he gets in those shoes, and he goes running. But there's days where he doesn't want to.
Yep.
But there's never days where he doesn't, right? So yep. That's the difference. Because, and also admitting that. I hate when people say, oh, I never have a tough day, I'm this, I'm that. You could be the most successful person in the world. You have days where you're doubting yourself. You
Absolutely.
Have days where you don't want to do this anymore, or you question why you're doing this, or I don't want to go into work today, or I don't want to stay up late tonight and work on whatever, or I don't want to go to the gym.
Yeah.
Like, everyone has that. That's almost one of the most, I know you have to put up a strong front, but sometimes that just drives me nuts.
I think it's a way too, like, it's one of those things where, like,
I'm gonna stay positive in that, I understand, but don't bullshit people.
Yeah.
Like, weakness is okay.
Weakness is a real thing.
I mean, like, just like, well, to show that you can get through it.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. That's the biggest.
That's the strength.
Because
right?
It's easy. It's easy to do this when you're motivated, right? And like, you can apply this statement to like any.
Oh, my 20s. Fuck, I couldn't wait to go to the gym.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I would go to bed. Like, can't wait to get up, because I even say to people,
I'm
going to
bed right now so I can wake up early.
I even say the only thing I like about my day is the gym.
Yeah.
I used to say that all the time. That used to be my big thing to say. The only thing that makes me happy is the gym.
Yeah.
And now it's just part of it's a lifestyle. I do enjoy it, but there are times where somebody's like, I don't feel like going. But you go.
Yeah.
But yes, you can. It's all relative, right?
Yeah. I would say, like, you know, like, even like, you know, another step to that is, like, for me, a lot of my other choices that I make throughout the course of my day, throughout the course of my lifestyle, I guess, is based on the influence that it's gonna have on my workout. You know what I mean? Like, so in the moment, like, do I wanna stay up and watch some Netflix? Maybe, right? But if I do, how tired am I gonna be, and how much am I gonna drag ass in the workout the next day? Right?
Right.
Probably a lot, right? And if I'm tracking my workout, right? Like, now I end up noticing, like, wait, I did 6 reps last time, I can barely do 4 today. Now that's gonna ruin my whole day.
That's an interesting point.
Right.
Like, what do you do? Say you did come into the gym and you get on that max and you're gonna follow the same routine you followed before, but then all of a sudden you just did 4 reps and you barely did it, but you did 6 last time.
I'm smoked.
Okay, would you continue on the workout and feel like a bag of shit and be depressed about it? Not depressed is a weird word, but, you know, not happy with the workout?
Yeah.
Or would you, like, say, because this is the harder thing to do, because most people wouldn't do this, would you switch everything up and just do everything, like, do all the different exercises?
I guess it depends.
That's probably the best way to do it, to keep a mindset, right?
Yeah.
Because you can get a good workout another way. Because if you go in there and all of a sudden you start right away, it's a shitty workout.
Yeah.
It's not going to get any better.
No. Yeah.
Because you're not all of a sudden going to do 5 next set.
The reality is that not every day we're going to feel 100%, right? So we are going to have some peaks and valleys along the way. What I try to make sure is that, like, you know, like, I'm gonna try to revisit what the hell did I do in the past day, 2 days, maybe 3 days that set me up for this, like, kind of subpar performance, right? Like, and try to make sure that, like, you know, because, like, you know, in a lot of ways, I think a lot of people would agree that, you know, like, you know, the workout part of the day is the best part of the day a lot of times, right? So, you know, like, there's nothing that sets your day, the tone for your day, like having a kick-ass workout and you just feel like a million bucks after, whatever. Like, your mindset is on a whole different level for the rest of the day.
Right? That's true. I kind of go through the same with the thing with the, if you're doing exercise, another thing you should do too, which you wouldn't do when you're younger, you start to do, say you're doing a bench and all of a sudden you go, oh, my shoulder feels weird.
Yeah.
Instead, you should take, obviously, right away, switch the exercises.
Yeah.
For the day.
Yeah.
That just makes sense, right? But back in the day, we wouldn't. We'd just like, okay, you just gotta stretch you out a bit more.
When we're 20, we're indestructible, right?
Yeah. I remember I always have, like, oh, my neck hurts. But you still, you'd go in there and work out. Yeah. Oh,
but
my shoulder.
This was the plan, so this is what I'm doing.
Yeah, and you don't care about, like, did you feel it? What do you mean, feel it?
Yeah.
I got it from here to here.
That's
5
it.
Times.
There you go.
It was like, okay. Kim. Probably a lot of your shit you take it out of. A lot of a tangent here.
We'll see what's up.
We'll see what's up. I guess I gotta at least talk about the shirt. We're not gonna tell a lot about it.
Oh shit.
Because I'm gonna do a little story. I'm gonna tell a story on TikTok and Instagram about what this was, right?
Oh yeah.
But basically what it was is Sunny Z. I call him a friend of mine, but he used to be, I know him mostly through IDFA stuff, right? Because he'd compete himself, and he also brought competitors. But then I saw him on social media talk about he does pro wrestling. And I'm like, okay, I create this workout warrior character, and I always thought that he had a kind of a vibe with the wrestling culture, right? Mm-hmm. So I approached Sunny Z and said, hey, do you think we did any big footage together? Oh, by the way, I'm the workout warrior. But don't tell anybody because you'll never see me on TikTok say I'm the workout warrior. No one knows I'm the workout warrior on TikTok. And there's like, that channel's getting millions of views.
It's like a whole thing.
But I never say who I am, right? But on the only in the warrior room you're gonna see me talk about that I am the workout warrior. So when you see this guy here behind me, people think I'm nuts, but it's catching on.
That's it.
And there is a vision. Because there's a warrior within everyone.
Yep.
So, and that's what he represents. Because no one else is really talking about the workout warrior and actually put a face to it. But I did.
That's it.
So hey, there you go. Call me crazy, call me nuts.
That's it.
But baby, call me. Okay, so what did I say? So Sunny Z. Yeah, so that's why I got his shirt. Because I met up with him yesterday. We went out a little north past Barrie, and I went to a pro wrestling training facility, yep. I guess you'd call it. So there's a ring there and everything, and then we put together like a little storyboard line of like between me and him, but that's about all I'm gonna say. And I'm gonna start dropping the videos soon. So when I do, make sure you like them and watch them.
That's
and
wild.
All that kind of stuff. It's gonna be kind of funny because we do like a, that's all I'm gonna say. So yeah, so I get the word, I become the workout warrior, and Sunny Z, whether we fight or not, that's to be determined. That's for you to see.
That's it.
So you gotta check that out. So the official workout warrior and Sunny Z are gonna be some clips coming up probably the next few days.
That's it.
So that's gonna be fun.
Oh snap.
So that was pretty crazy. Pro wrestling is an art. Let me tell you, these guys, there was another wrestler there as well, and they started helping me out because they know the lingo, they know the vibe, they've been in the industry, they're like pro wrestlers for over 20 years.
How to work it.
In the indie circuit, I guess, there's an indie circuit.
Yeah.
There's a lot of guys who do this too, and girls. So they were telling me about this, we were just sitting there, I feel like a big kid again, like I got the costume on, we're talking stories, they're like, oh, we're gonna do this, we're gonna do that. It was almost like playtime. And that's why these guys do this.
There you go.
Like they're on the indie circuit. It's not really, yeah, it's like growing up playtime. So yeah. As we were talking, we were running stories back and forth of what I'm gonna say and what he's gonna say. It was just hilarious. Like it was so much fun. So you're gonna see that fun time in videos coming up.
There you go.
I'm trying to get JP there, but JP has a real job, right?
My boss sucks. Like it's a whole thing.
Right? By the way, he's his own boss.
Self-employed.
So his boss does suck. And mine, I don't know what the hell I am. Like I run the IDFA and all that stuff, but I can do it mostly from home, so I just get up when I get up, right?
That's it.
I do have other responsibilities, but that's mostly weekends and stuff, right? During the week, and that was another thing about discipline, because Sunny actually called me up. He messaged me on Instagram, which that's what people do nowadays, right? We don't call each other. He messaged me on Instagram. He says, so what are you doing Tuesday? And originally I had nothing to do except for just wake up at my own leisure, right? So now I have something I have to do, a schedule, and I have to get the costume ready and all my stuff.
God,
so,
oh my God. Alarm clock.
I had to set an alarm, all these things, right? So anyway, I did all that. At first you go there, you're like, oh my God, what am I gonna do? But as it got going and we got going, you're excited you did it and you're happy you did it, right? So
yeah.
That's where sometimes things are worth it.
That's it. There you go, right? Because if it was easy, it wouldn't be worthwhile, right?
If it was easy, everyone would have a muscle costume.
That's it.
And jumping around in pro wrestling rings at my age. Like,
that's
come on.
It. Come on.
I almost feel like I'm nuts.
There you go, right?
But you feel like a big kid.
That's
so
it.
So to feel like, if something makes you feel like a big kid, it's almost worth doing, right?
Yeah.
Because that's, There's nothing like feeling like a big kid again, right? Because when do you get really excited like a kid anymore at this age, right?
Exactly.
Not really.
I think as adults, there's not enough play.
Because right? This is getting weird all of a sudden. it's almost like cosplay gone wild, right?
Shit.
We're like literally wrestling in there. Like this guy gave me a chest. Oh, yeah, here's a funny thing. Sonny, like, he said, okay, just stay still. And he charged at me. And I'm wearing the costume and he said, I just want you to feel that adrenaline of some of a bro, like a man coming to tackle you.
Yeah.
I said, yeah, there was adrenaline. Yeah. And he bumped me in the chest, but he didn't hit me hard to their pro wrestling standards.
Yeah.
But funny thing is, like, I look today, it's not big enough, but I have a little bruise on my chest.
Oh, shit.
It's kind of funny. Because it did kind of hurt, but not a lot. Like,
yeah.
You get hurt, it's like, whoa, that kind of hurt. I wasn't expecting that. And that was them, like, that was the faking it.
Yeah,
like it's pro wrestling's fake, right? So that's the faking it. But and watching them run around the ring and how hard they hit.
You get backlash now from saying that.
Oh yeah. Oh no, Sonny's 100% down with me that it's sports entertainment. He's an entertainer.
Entertainment.
And he's entertaining.
There you go.
And I'm gonna tell you right now, if I don't have to like, what is it called? Toot my own horn. The freaking workout warrior, that guy's electrifying. And he's entertaining. When you see the clip, he's entertaining.
Oh shit.
I do call outs and everything, it's crazy.
It's wild.
I get into a workout warrior, almost like the Hulk Hogan vibe.
Oh yeah!
Anyways.
That's it.
So what do you think, JP? We went on some...
like we went all over the place.
Dance and rant.
And you know what we didn't talk about?
Oh shit, what? Your mustache? That too.
We didn't talk about the mustache. But we didn't talk about 24 hours, 10 workouts.
Fuck. Are we going to talk about that right now?
We're going to talk about that next time.
Hey! Yeah, next time.
Yeah. Tune in next time.
So tune in next time. So now we got to remember. So now we got to have a plan.
That's it.
So tune in next time for episode
four.
We'll talk about the 24 hours of workouts.
10 workouts in 24 hours.
That's it. So 10 workouts in 24 hours and it went from between.
So this was to celebrate the IDFA 10-year anniversary.
Yeah, and we just gave this crazy idea, but we had no time to plan it. It was like, basically, here's the idea, we start tomorrow.
Jump in the car, let's go. All right.
It was nuts.
We'll leave you
I almost forgot about it. How long ago was that? That would have been like almost 7 years ago.
That would have been, yeah. Yeah.
So 2015 probably, because it's 2000. Whatever. So 10 workouts in 24 hours. From here to Montreal.
Yeah.
And we stopped at a bunch of gyms. So we'll tell you that whole story
next
episode four. All right, so we'll see you then.
So the question is,
what
you gonna do, Shaun?
What you gonna do when the workout warrior comes after you?
Oh snap.
I don't even know what the hell.
Cut.
That's it.